constructing an angle equal to the given angle. Let ABC be an angle whose measure is not known. Draw a line L and mark a point P on it, as shown here. Place the compasses at B and draw an arc to cut the rays of angle ABC at X and Y, as shown here. With the same setting of the compasses, draw an arc with P as center, cutting the line L at Q as shown here. With Q as center and radius equal to XY, cut the previous arc at R as shown here. Join PRQ as shown here. Angle RPQ is the required angle equal to angle ABC. Using a ruler and compasses, let L be a line and P be a point outside the line L. With P as center and with any radius, draw an arc cutting the line L at A and B as shown here. With A and B as centers and with radius greater than half AB, draw two arcs on the other side of the line L intersecting each other at Q as shown here. Join PQ and produce it in both the directions to form the line PQ. Then the line PQ is the required line. Using a ruler and compasses, let L be a line and P be a point on it. With P as center and a convenient radius, draw a semicircle that intersects the line L at two points R and S as shown here. With R as center and any radius greater than half of RS, draw an arc as shown here. With center S and the same radius as in step 2, draw another arc, cutting the arc drawn in step 2 at Q as shown here. Join PQ and produce it in both the direction to form the line PQ as shown here. PQ is the required line. Constructing the bisector of an angle, let angle ABC be the given angle. With B as center and any suitable radius, draw an arc intersecting the arms AB and AC at P and Q respectively. With P and Q as centers and radius greater than half PQ, draw two arcs intersecting each other at R. Join BR and produce it to get the ray BR. The ray BR is the angle bisector of an angle ABC. Complete angle. An angle measuring exactly 360 degree is called the complete angle. Here, angle F is a complete angle. Perpendiculars. Two lines or line segments or rays are said to be perpendiculars if they intersect each other at right angles. Here, the lines L and M are perpendicular because they intersect, making a right angle of 90 degree. Perpendicular bisector of a line segment. Let AB be a line segment and M be its midpoint. A line passing through M, the midpoint, and perpendicular to the line segment AB is called the perpendicular bisector of AB. Here, the line L is the perpendicular bisector of AB. Transversal. AB and CD are two lines in the same plane. PQ intersects AB at X and CD at Y. Here, the line PQ is called a transversal to the lines AB and CD. A line that intersects two or more lines at distinct points is called a transversal.